Do you need to extract some of your Power BI data and analyze it in Excel? Don't miss this video. Hello everyone, Shab is back with another interesting video. It's highly possible that your managers ask you to download the data behind the visualizations. Maybe they want to do some further analysis. There are different ways to do that. For example, you can create a button to download the Excel file into SharePoint. But because of the security in many of the organizations, maybe they block you to do that. So what's the solution? In this video, I will show you how you can send the data behind your visualizations in a form of a CSV file. So watch this video up to the end and don't miss any step. If it's the first time you're watching my videos, please subscribe to the channel. Get the notification for the new upcoming videos. You can also follow me on LinkedIn and read Power BI articles on my blog. Stay tuned. Consider we have a report like this one, and the same as many other reports, you can interact with slicers. And also, you can easily select a category or some specific values on visual. This is really cool. But your report users ask you how we can download and extract the data available on this table to play, check, and analyze. Here is where the problem arises. Because Power BI won't allow your end users to download some part of data based on their selections. Don't worry, I'm here to teach you how to deal with this issue. So, what's the solution? The solution is using Power Automate in Power BI. Yes, that's correct. Power Automate helps us to extract the selected data and use it for other purposes. Let's see how we can use it. Fortunately, since last year, Power Automate Visual is available in Power BI visualization list, and we don't need to go to Power Automate website to create many of the manual flows that should be performed by pressing a button. And we can create them directly in Power BI. The first step is to choose Power Automate Visual. When I click on it, you can see this visual on the canvas. But to know how I can use it, take a little bit of time and watch this video. To start with Power Automate, the first thing we need is to import the required columns into the visual data field. Okay, let's go back to this page. Consider we want to extract the data from this table for our users. So, instead of creating a new Power Automate visual and select every column one by one and drag them into the data field, I just click on this table visual and copy it by pressing Ctrl and C, and paste it again by pressing Ctrl and V. As you can see, a copy of this table created, and I can move it and change the size, but it's exactly similar to the other table. Now, what I have to do is, when this table is selected, just click on the Power Automate visual, and that's it. You can see this table changed to a Power Automate visual. And all the data fields are now available here in the data field. So easy. You can also add any other field you like, but for now, we don't need to use any extra fields, and these fields are enough for our demonstration. I just resize and place the visual where I like. Then we need to press on these three dots and choose Edit. In the new window, you can see here previously created flows. Or here below you can see the templates to use. But what we need to do is pressing on New and then Instant Cloud Flow. Then on this new page, we need to add a new step. And here search for Initialize Variable. Then we have two fields here. First, we should choose a name for it. For example, I choose Table Content. The second field is where we need to choose the variable type. In this field, we choose array. This is very important to create a variable with array format type, because at the end, our data fields in CSV file will be placed in different columns, which is very easy for end users to work with. Otherwise, if you simply create a CSV file, you will receive a simple comma separated values file in only one column, and you have to split the cells, which is really hard for someone who is not expert with Excel. Next, we need to add a new step and search for append to array variable. After selecting it, in the first field, we choose table content, what we created earlier. The value field is where we need to define the values based on a JSON format. So I open a curly bracket, press enter for 2 times, and then close the curly bracket. The values should be inserted between the curly brackets. In JSON files, we need to define each value in the form of a pair. The first part of a pair defines the name of that attribute, and the second one defines the value. For example, here you can see the first data field is product name. So here inside the double quotation mark, I write product name. Then I put a colon and open and close double quotation again. In the second one, I should insert the value. So at this stage, if dynamic content was open for you, that's fine. But if not, click on add dynamic content. And then you can see all these data fields available here. What I need to do is just simply scroll up or down to find the product name from these dynamic content fields. And we'll choose it to place inside the second quotation marks. It is how easily we can create a pair of values. Then to add another pair, we just put a comma at the end of this line and do the same process until we add all desired columns. But notice that the last pair doesn't need any comma after it. Then we need to add a new step and search for create CSV table, and then choose table content variable from the list. Up to here, we could create a CSV table in the form of array, exactly what we need. Now I'll add a new step and search for send an email version 2. When selected, in the To section, I add user email from Power BI dynamic content. This will allow us to send email to whoever pressed the button. In the subject field, we choose a subject for our email and also add a content for it. By clicking on Show Advanced option, you can see more details. For example, you can define sending an email to a person as CC. And here in the attachment name section, I choose a name for our CSV file. Then write.csv to define the format of the file as CSV. And finally, in attachment content, I choose output as the output in previous step. I just press on save. And then choose a name related to our flow from here. When finished, just press on save and apply, and then go back to the report. Now here you can see the Power Automate visual shape changed to a button. You can edit the format like many other visuals, and it's out of the scope of this video. If you apply any slicer or choose any record, you can only export those ones. For example, here I choose these few rows by holding the control button and selecting them. When my selection finished, I will click on the button. As you can see, first it shows triggering. And then after some seconds, you can see it shows triggered. So now I open my email and wait for some seconds. And here it is. I received an email with the content we like and a CSV file attached to it. Let me download and open it. And that's it. It's exactly what we are looking for. If you enjoyed this video, don't forget to like and share it and hit the subscribe button for the new upcoming videos. You can follow me on LinkedIn and read Power BI articles on my blog. Have a good day, all Power BI lovers.